राइट, सेल एक्टिविटी कंप्यूटर सिलेक्टेड। ऑलराइट, सो लेट्स स्टार्ट नाउ, लेट देम कम एंड जॉइन, नो प्रॉब्लम। दिस इज हेलो लास्ट क्लास वी डिस्कस द कैटलिस्ट यूज्ड इन द रिफाइनरीज, राइट। सो जियोलाइट इज वन ऑफ द कैटलिस्ट यूज्ड इन द रिफाइनरीज अमंग अदर कैटलिस्ट, राइट, बिकॉज ऑफ दिस सिक्स शेप सिलेक्टिव नेचर। शेप सिलेक्टिव नेचर दैट मीन्स its molecular size is that your porous structure, whereby you see the porous structure here, some molecules of this size can enter, rest cannot enter. So it's that shape selectivity, it has got shape selectivity. Now this one is that is the zeolite structure of large open pore. There are some small open pore, right? We will talk about it. There is zeolite is a natural your clear type product which can be obtained from volcanic ashes, from that volcanic eruptions. It's that natural zeolite. However, we can synthesize this zeolite based on this alumina silica sodium hydroxide, sodium oxide, iron oxide. Based on this composition, we can synthesize it. Those who came late, please write your name in the chat box. Right. So, zeolite, best. Known as the discoverer of nickel, geologist Axel Cronstedt, that he first coined this name and gave this name to zeolite, that is to a special kind of rock, because it literally meaning boiling stone. Boiling stone, stone that is your just as if it's boiling. Right, so zeolites are hydrated aluminosilicates made from interlinked tetrahydra of alumina and silica. This tetrahydra LO4 minus, they say 4 minus, this tetrahydra of this alumina and silica, L2O3 is alumina, actually silica is SiO2. However, this is the tetrahydra of this form and making it hydrated aluminosilicate. So this is that general formula, general concept of zeolite. In a simple words, they are solids with a relatively open three-dimensional crystal structure, open pore, three-dimensional crystal structure built from the elements of aluminium, oxygen, and silicon. Actually, that means L2O3, aluminium oxygen, no need, just write it alumina and silicon, because we are not writing it as silicon oxide like this. Anyway, if you said that elements, okay, then it's okay, aluminium, oxygen, silicon. Yeah, sodium, potassium, magnesium, plus water molecules trapped in the gaps between them. That means it has this composition, this your the composition is that it's L2O3, SiO2, then Na2O Then your Fe3, Fe2O3, these are the things associated with this zeolite. So this has, as I just mentioned, as a pore structure, and it depends on the type of zeolites. There are many types of zeolites, and it's used as a catalyst. A defining feature of zeolite is that their frameworks are made up of four coordinated atoms forming tetrahedra. And these tetrahedra are linked together by their corners and make a rich variety of beautiful structures. The framework structure may contain linked cases, cavities, or channels. These are the cavities, channels, which are big enough to allow small molecules to enter. However, bigger molecules will not be able to enter. That's the shape selective nature of zeolite. The voids in zeolites are interconnected and form long wide channels of various sizes depending on the compound. So these channels allow the easy drift of the resident ions and molecules into and out of the structure. So there we get something inside, it will reside here. Later is that catalytic your part, it will do, that means this zeolite will act as the catalyst. When the molecules get inside and it's cracked or reformed or any changes that zeolite brings in, and later it will pass through, it will come out. So zeolites have regular openings in their fixed size which let small molecules to pass through while trap larger ones. That's why they are sometimes referred to as molecular sieves. Molecular sieves, right? So two types of zeolites are available, natural zeolite and synthetic zeolite. At present, there are over 40 naturally occurring zeolite frameworks that are known forming in both volcanic and sedimentary rocks. So volcanic eruption, from there we find this zeolite coming out from the ground, from this earth, right? So the most commonly mined naturally formed zeolites include cabazite, clinoptolite, mordenite. These are the name of the zeolites, that is clay type product. Okay, so dozens of artificial synthetic zeolites, around 150 almost like this or more than that, have been designed for specific purposes because we need it as a catalyst. It can be used as an ion exchanger. It can exchange the ion, and then we have this use in water purification because it can exchange ions, and then ions will be trapped. So this way it can be used in that as an ion exchanger. It can be used as an absorbent. It can be used as a catalyst. So the best known of which are zeolite A, zeolite X, Y, and molecular sieve zeolite ZSM5. These are the synthetic zeolites. So zeolite A, they have their specific characteristics, that is this shape with angstroms of this size, suppose pore size 5 angstrom, 3 angstrom, 8 angstrom, 12 angstrom, right? So 12 angstrom is bigger, 5 is less, A is low, right? So zeolite type A, that means based on this angstrom, is categorized, means your pore size, it categorized as zeolite A. Commonly used as a laundry detergent, okay, can be used, okay. Zeolites X and Y, these two types of different zeolites of fausacite. Fausacites is the name of another naturally occurring zeolite, that is fausacites also, but it can be synthesized, these fausacites. If it is synthesized in two different ways, based on silica alumina ratio, aluminium ratio, aluminium and silicon. this ratio, based on this, we can produce two different types, and it's named as zeolite X and zeolite Y. So these zeolite X and zeolite Y can be derived from fausocytes as another mineral, and it's this one is synthetic zeolite used for catalytic cracking. And petroleum zeolite, ZSM5, that is molecular sieve zeolite, that right this way, 5 is that angstrom, a branded name for pentacyl zeolite. So unlike natural zeolite, which occur in random forms and mixed synthesizes, synthetic zeolites are manufactured in very precise and uniform sizes, typically from about 1 micrometer to 1 millimeter to suit a particular application. In other words, they are made a certain size to trap molecules of a certain size inside them. That's why it used as an ion exchanger. It will trap this one inside and it will release, because it has got SiO2, AlO2, Al2O3. Besides that, Na2O, sodium oxide. This sodium oxide can be replaced with any other metals. The sodium can go to the solution, other metal can come to this position. Right, so this has got ion exchanging properties. So, however, we'll talk about its catalytic properties. So, zeolites, the pore sizes based on that 8-member ring, that is your silica aluminia, this ring is that, like we have carbon, hydrocarbon, like carbon, 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 5 carbons. These are the silica aluminia mole, that is that ratio, your of that molecule. And suppose 8-membered ring, 10, 12, 14. Based on this, the sizes also depend. It's 3 to 4 angstrom, that is 0.35 to 0.45 nanometer, right? So zeolite A, this is called zeolite A. ZSM5, molecular sieve zeolite, 5 means 5 pent, your, it's 10 member, 10 ring, and it's your angstrom, that is this from here to here, the distance, distance from here to here or from here to here, is that the pore size is that 5 angstrom. Average is that 4.5 to 6 angstrom, or 0.45 to 0.6 nanometer. And this is 12 bearing structure, zeolite Y, and it's that 6 to 8 angstrom, and this is 7 to 1, 10 angstrom. So these are that types of synthetic zeolites. So industrial important catalyst zeolites as that, these are classified into 3 groups according to aluminium silica, silicon, L over SI, aluminium silicon ratio in their frameworks. So if it is low silica, silica, that means your SI is, if it is less, or aluminium rich zeolites, that means the aluminium part is higher, we call it as zeolite A. And zeolite X, based on this ratio, and we find that their pore sizes are different. So both zeolites A and X are nearly saturated in aluminium in their framework composition, with the molar ratio of silicon to aluminium of approximately 1, which is considered as highest aluminium content possible in tetrahedral aluminosilicate frameworks. So these compositional characteristics combined give them the most highly heterogeneous surface knowing among porous materials, due to exposed cationic charges nested in an aluminosilicate framework, which results in high field gradients. We have other cations resting on this aluminium silicate framework, as I told you, it can be iron even, it can be sodium ion, it can be potassium ion, is associated in this framework, it's also added. So their surface is highly selective for water, polar and polarizable molecules, which serve as the basis for many applications, particularly in drying and purifications. These are other applications other than catalysts. We'll see their catalytic part, right? Anyway, we should know that what are the zeolite types of zeolites. So low silica or alumina rich zeolites A and X, that is silica alumina ratio is approximately 1. This is that shape of this zeolite. So if you see that this is the pore structure, this getting in, right? Molecules can get in and crack, or your cyclic formation, isomerization, many things happens inside. So intermediate silica zeolites, these are zeolite Y, modernite, zeolite L, natural zeolites, that is ratio, silicon alumina ratio is 2. Silicon alumina ratio 2.5, 2 is to 5. Natural zeolites, however, so intermediate level silica, that means just not too high, not too low. Just now we have seen very low silica, which means very high aluminium content. So this is in between, just of both the contents of aluminium and silicon are just balanced way. It was recognized that the tetrahedral aluminium oppositions in the zeolite frameworks provide a site of instability for attack by acid and water vapor of steam that makes synthetic zeolites A and X less stable than their natural analogs, which have superior stability characteristics reflecting higher silicon to aluminium molar ratio of 3.5. So we have this ratio depending on that your properties depend, and their catalytic part also depend on that. Therefore, zeolites with higher content of silicon were needed primarily to improve stability characteristics, both thermal and acids. Right. So we need to increase higher silicon to improve this stability, and both the thermal part and the acidic nature, that should, it should be controlled this way with this increase in silicon content. So intermediate, okay. So the third commercially important molecular sieve zeolites was zeolite type Y, with a silicon aluminium ratio of 1.5 to 3, and a framework topology like that of zeolites X and the rare zeolites mineral fausacite. So this is intermediate silica type of, that is your Y type zeolite. So we will see which type of zeolites are used in industry if it is told that yes, we use zeolite. Now the question comes, what type of zeolite you are using? Are you talking about zeolite Y, zeolite X, zeolite A, modernite, or ZSM5, or any natural cabazite, or monitorite, or other type of zeolites? Because with this information, we can understand their acidic properties, means your in the surface, or how good it is to have any catalytic reaction. Their pore sizes are also important to consider. Their other characteristics, their surface area, all these are coming from their synthetic part, which means how we are going to synthesize, or what type of zeolite we are going to use or is being used there in the industry. So we should know that what are the types of zeolites and where are its applications, these applications of as a zeolite catalyst. So besides improvement in stability over the more aluminous X, the differences in composition and structures had a striking, unpredicted effect on the properties, making zeolite Y-based catalyst valuable in many important catalytic applications involving hydrocarbon conversion. We have previously discussed that we have hydrocarbon available in the petroleum products, that is your refineries, refinery oils. We have a long chain hydrocarbons, right?